Stripe is one of the most famous payment processing solutions to easily collect and manage online payments. In this tutorial, I'll cover everything from the process of getting started, adding your products, creating payment links, generating invoices, coupons, and fully responsive pricing tables that can seamlessly integrate into your website. So without wasting any time, let's get started. Hello everyone and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you are new here, then please like this video and subscribe to my channel so I can keep on making more videos for you and provide you more solutions. Alright, let's open the Stripe website. If you already have an account, go to the sign in. But if you don't have one, then click on the sign up to create a new account. Provide it with your email address, name, location, and the password. After that, click on create an account. And it will ask you to verify the email address. Check your mailbox to open the email and verify your email address. Next, you have to provide your business details to start collecting payments. Click on continue. Select your location and type of business. Next, you have to put your personal details, name, email address, date of birth, and address. You can also provide your social insurance number, but that is optional. Next, you have to select your business industry. If you have a website, put the domain name here, and if you don't have one, you can simply put your social media link here. Then give it a business description. Next, type your desired statement descriptor. This will appear on customer's bank statement. Same goes for shorten descriptor. Then you have to provide your phone number. Next, input your bank account details. That includes the transit number, institution number, and the account number. Click on continue. Here you can also set up two-step authentication to enhance the security of your account. You can use an authentication app, add a security key, or use a text message. So just select whatever is your preference. I'm gonna use Google Authenticator. You can download the Google Authenticator from your mobile app store. Open the app once installed. Click on the bottom right plus icon and select scan a QR code. Scan this code and it will be linked to your mobile app. Type the code that you see in the app. After that, make sure to copy and download these codes for backup. And that's it, Google Authentication is now enabled. Now, whenever I log into my account, I have to get a new code from this app and put it here to log in. And this code changes every 60 seconds, so this is great for an extra layer of security. Next, you can select your text category. And finally, check all the information and click on Agree and Submit. Alright, once your account is approved, then you can use all of its features and services. This is the dashboard and here you can see the overall performance and analytics of your business. You can see how much money you have made today, your total account balance, and the scheduled payouts. If you scroll down, you can see the overview of your account. You can apply these filters to get the data of a specific date and time. You can see your gross volume, net volumes from sales, failed payments, new customers, and the top customers who spend the most with you. Now, there are a couple of very useful things here at the top. Stripe offers a very interesting features to create and manage multiple accounts, which can be very useful if you have different businesses or projects. You can create a separate profile for each one of your business or project. This way, your sales record won't mix up, which can save you a lot of time and effort. Another great feature of Stripe is the test mode that allows you to test all of its features and integrations before going live. It's like a practice area where you can add test customers, create payment links, and make test purchases without spending real money to ensure everything's working as expected. If you are using Stripe for the first time, then you can turn on the test mode to try out different things. And once you get familiar and confident with its interface and features, then you can turn it off and enjoy using Stripe. Let's click on the Payments tab, and here you'll see an overview of all the payments that happened in your account. You can see their status, either the payment was successful, refunded, or failed. You can also use these filters to see only the succeeded payments, refunded payments, uncaptured, or failed payments. You also have a section for disputes where you can manage all of your disputes and see their status. Next, you have the fraud and risk. This is where you'll see an overview of the fraudulent and risky transactions that Stripe has detected as unsafe, so Stripe will block those payments. You can further customize your fraudulent protection with advanced features. This is a premium tool of Stripe called Radar. You can try its 30-day free trial if you want. Next is the Balances tab. Here you'll see your balance, upcoming payouts, and when they are scheduled to arrive in your bank account. If you click on this Edit Settings, you can also manage the payout schedule and the payout speed. Alright, let's go to the Customers tab. Here you'll be able to see all the customers in your business. You can see their names, email addresses, default payment methods, and some other details. Whenever someone buys a product or service from you, the details of that person will automatically be added to the Customers tab. But if you want, you can manually add a customer as well. To do that, click on the Add Customer. Put their name, email address, and the billing information. After that, click on the Add Customer and it will be added to the list along with the other customers. Moving on to the products. For instance, if you want to charge people directly from Stripe, then you can create a product and generate a payment link or an invoice to request payment from a customer. As you can see, I already have created some products here. To create a new product, click on Add Product. You can add the product or service name, add a description, and upload an image here. Next, you have the price information, and Stripe offers 5 different pricing models. Select standard pricing if you have only one price for your product or service. Choose package pricing if you are selling products in a bulk quantity. For example, if you charge $100 for every 10 units, so if a customer buys 16 or 20 units, then he would pay $200. Select graduated pricing if you have different pricing for different number of units within an order. For example, you can charge $10 per unit for the first 100 units. And then you can charge $5 per unit for the next 100 units. And finally, you can charge $3 per unit for any quantity exceeding 200 units. Select volume pricing if you charge the same price for each unit based on the total number of units sold. For example, if someone buys 100 units, then you would charge $10 per unit for the 100 units. But if someone buys 200 units, then you would charge $5 per unit for 200 units. But if someone buys more than 200 units, then you would charge $3 per unit. Lastly, select customer chooses price if you want your customers to input their desired amount. This is best if you're collecting donations or asking people to support you. You can add a suggested amount. Also set the minimum and maximum amount here. I'm gonna choose the standard pricing and this is what most of you guys are gonna need. You can also show this price in multiple currencies. For example, if I add US dollar as currency, it's gonna show this amount converted in US dollars as well. And you can add as many currencies as you want. You can set up either one-time payment or recurring payment if you want to create a subscription plan with different billing periods. I'm gonna select one-time payment. These additional options down here won't be visible to the customers, but you can add these to stay organized. Once you have put all the information, say product, and it will be added as a product. Now you can create a payment link for any of the added products that will take customers to a payment page where they can purchase your product or service. In the next video, I'll show you the complete process of creating a payment link to collect online payments and how you can customize the payment page by adding your logo, your brand colors, and also collect additional information from customers by adding custom fields. So make sure to check the next video. You can find the link in the description. Next, you have the coupon section. You can create a coupon code and give it to your customer to give them a discount. I've created a separate video dedicated to that, so make sure to find the link in the description. Next is the shipping rates. If you are selling physical products, then you can add the shipping rates as well. You can add information about the shipping service that you are using and add the estimated shipping time. Next is the tax rates. You can configure your tax settings or manually add the tax rate. You can select the tax type from VAT, GST, or add a custom type. Select your required region and then add the tax percentage. Click here and it'll be added as tax rate. Next is the pricing tables, and this is a great feature of Stripe. You can create a fully responsive, beautiful looking pricing table so customers can compare different pricing tiers and then choose the pricing that suits them. You can also embed this pricing table into your website or any other platform that allows third-party code embedding. So it's a very helpful tool and I've created a separate video on how to create a pricing table and how you can embed it in your website. So make sure to watch the full series of this Stripe tutorial. You can find all the links in the description. Alright, next is the billing section and this provides an overview of your subscriptions, the active subscribers, net volume, average revenue per subscriber and more. You can also see and manage the invoices, subscriptions and quotes. Basically, it helps you keep track of how much money you are making and how many customers are staying with your service. The report section allows you to generate financial reports. Stripe offers various reports like balance, payout reconciliations, revenue recognition, and conversion performance. Stripe's Connect feature lets you integrate Stripe payments and financial services into other platforms and marketplaces. If you have a platform where multiple people are selling or offering services, Stripe Connect helps you collect payments from buyers and then distribute the money to the individual sellers, all while taking care of things like taxes and fees. It's like a payment manager that can take care of all the complicated money flow so you can focus more on running your business. Click on More and here you get some other products offered by Stripe. Most of you guys may not need these, but you can explore these if you want. The Developer's Dashboard provides necessary tools to create APIs and webhooks that developers can use to integrate payment processing in websites and mobile applications. It shows you what's working and what's not all in one place. This makes it easier and faster to fix problems and keep payments running smoothly. For example, you'll have to create an API key and a webhook if you want to integrate Stripe with a WooCommerce website to collect payments. In the top right corner, you can see the settings option. And here you can manage all the settings for Stripe products. Next, you have the business settings, where you can manage all aspects of your business, including account details, public details, business details, and more. In the next video, I'll show you how to add your logo and brand colors to customize the appearance of Stripe products. If you go to the top right profile icon and click on the profile, here you'll find some additional options to change your email address, name, and password. Next, you have the two-step authentication settings. I already have enabled the Google Authenticator, but you can add a security key or use a text message as well. Lastly, if for some reason you want to delete your account, then go back to the settings, click on the account details, and here you'll find the option to close your account. So that's the end of this video. Make sure to check the next episode of this Stripe tutorial. You can find all the links in the description.